Hello and welcome to this video showing you the new Consolidation Analysis Tool. It's a GDSS tool that was designed to help analyze and interpret consolidation data obtained from GDSLab. It will be shipped on GDSLab version 2.8.1.3 onwards, and I'll show you now how to launch the tool from GDSLab. So if you right-click on the graph, you will get a menu. First entry in the menu says Consolidation Analysis Current Stage. This will launch the Consolidation Analysis Tool, and the data displayed in the tool will be the data acquired by GDSLab in the current stage. Now the tool is open with an example data we collected earlier. In this case, odometer test, and we chose ASTM as the standard. The window shows two graphs, one of the Casagrande method, so it will be the data with respect of time in a logarithmic plot, and a Taylor method where data is plotted against square root of time, in this case, square root of minutes. You will also notice in black the data, and in blue and yellow, some constructs line. Here, the line is blue. Depending on the specimen type and the standard, we will have different construct lines, which will be automatically selected by the tool, but they can be manually adjusted if necessary. To do so, we click on the line, and we either drag the ends of the line, or we drag the line itself, and we can then select the best location. At the bottom, you will have the results from the tool. For the Casagrande method, odometer ASTM, we obtain T50, in this case, 201.5 seconds, and the value of CV, or CNew, of 9.44 times 10 to the power of minus 4 centimeters squared over seconds. For the Taylor method, we get 165 seconds, or a value of CNew of 4.999 times 10 to the power of minus 3 centimeters squared over seconds. Those results are automatically calculated from the data, and they are calculated every time we move the construct lines, or we change any of the parameters that are available for different specimen types and standards. If it's necessary to zoom on the graph to adjust precisely the construct line, we can click on this looking glass icon on the graph. Then we drag an area on the graph we want to zoom in. We can repeat it again if we want. So we click on the looking glass, and we select the area. From there, we can adjust the lines more precisely. And then once we're done, we just double click on the graph or press this icon to go back to the original graph. Same thing for this other graph. And double click. The standard chosen at the beginning of this test in GDSLab was ASTM in this case. Specimen type and standard are sent by GDSLab to the tool. And if necessary, we can change the standard inside the tool. We just need to go to data, change standard. A window will alert me that all the minor modifications to the line will be lost if I change the standard. I click on yes. Now I select, for example, the ISO standard. You will notice that the values have changed. You can easily see that the units have changed to meters squared over second. So the calculations will reflect the new standard. Please note that the source file that is opened by the tool generated by GDSLab won't change if you change the standard. So you can modify the standard in the tool, but when you reload the data, you will get the original standard. I will show you later how to save the new consolidation file with a new standard. Sometimes we launch the tool while a consolidation stage is in progress, so we are not sure, or we know that the consolidation phase hasn't finished. If we want to refresh the data from GDSLab, we can click on Data, Refresh Data, Manual Refresh. In this case, it won't change, but if there's new data points, they will be added to the data. But if we manually modify the lines and we want to maintain the new lines, well, we just need to click on Lock Linear Fits. That will tell the tool not to put the linear fit back into the default location. So I click on this, move the line, and then manually refresh. You will see the line stays there. If you want to reset the position of the linear fits, you just have to click on Graphs, Reset Linear Fit. That will put the construct line back to the original position. If for some reason we want to edit the source data displayed in the tool, we can do so by clicking on Data, Edit Source Data. This will alert me that if I then apply the changes to the data, this will reset the construct lines. Click on Yes, and I will have this window here. The top left graph shows the raw data. This is the raw data I get from GDSLab. In this case, this is displacement, axial displacement, which is increasing. The graph at the bottom is an overview of all the data in the graph. On the right, I have time and values obtained by GDSLab, plus some other data which is not available for this specimen type. I also have the ignored checkbox, which allows me to ignore points one by one. If otherwise I want to reduce manually the amount of data being displayed in the tool, I can do so by dragging this cursor here. And the graph above shows what will actually be present in the tool. So I'm reducing the data by more than half. And I click OK. And then the tool would say that the source data has been updated. So if you notice, it's missing some data at the end. I'll do it again, 3 minutes on data from the beginning, which will be way more noticeable. Now I have reset the tool to the original data, but I want to show you how to manually load different data files. Click on Open, File Open. Yes. Notice that the directory is under c-gdslab-consolidation-files. This is where GDSLab stores all the raw data obtained from consolidation tests. From here, I will load other data wrapped earlier. And you will notice the tool has changed. This is to reflect the new specimen type, which is triaxial. Again, standard is ASTM. Triaxial tests will have more results, more outputs, but also some user-defined parameters. In this case, you will notice there's a displacement axis. In this case, displacement will match volume change. But if necessary, you can drag on the axis to display it. or you can even hide the displacement by clicking on this checkbox. You will notice there's a drainage condition parameter, which can change in this case from one side to both sides, and this will reflect in different values of CNU being calculated. There's also a panel called strain velocity. From here, you can change the expected strain of failure in percentage. Default is 4%. The test type, for example, and other parameters. You will notice that some of the combo boxes are grayed out. This is because, for example, for ASTM standard and test type CU, there's no need to set the set side drains. And interpolation method is defaulted to Casagrande. Right, and these are the two outputs, rate of strain and strain velocity. If the tool successfully calculates strain velocity, in this case 5.722 times 10 to the power of minus 3 millimeters per minute, GDSLab will receive this value, which can be used then in subsequent stages. I'll show you what happens if I change test type to CD. You'll notice now side drains becomes available and interpretation method is set to Taylor. As an example, changing the standard, for example, to ISO changes the calculations, changes the unit, the available parameters, and for example here I can change the interpretation method to calculate strain velocity from Casagrande to Taylor. Again, you can change the construct lines position, you can tune them, you can refresh the data, so you can get all the features I showed you earlier. So let's say we don't like this data here. I've showed you earlier how to edit data. So let's do that now. And what I want to do is remove the first few minutes of the data, because I don't think the sample, I don't think the data is necessary, let's say. So notice that the first few points are all ignored. And notice how now we get the values of vertical strain and radial strain. Click on yes. And here it is. Maybe the data is still not good enough. Maybe we should have added more. But this shows an example on how to edit the data inside the tool. Now, like changing the standard, editing the data doesn't change the underlying data file generated by GDSLab. Therefore, reloading this GDS file, GDS consolidation file, will show all the data. In order to save a new consolidation file with the trim data, with a change standard, for example, we click on File, Export Consolidation File, and we can save a new consolidation file with the new trim data. Note that any change to the construct line, any manual change to the construct line, will not be saved. Finally, I want to show you some example data from a simple shear test. In this case, we don't have any construct line for the Casagrande method under the ASTM standard. But you can see we get some results, including strain velocity. For the full list of standard specimen types supported, please refer to the online help or please contact support@gdsinstruments.com. Thank you for watching.